Hello, 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 and welcome to another episode of Crazy Town Gaming. My name is Jonas. I'm your host. I'm here with
TNT Dynamite, the Explosive One. Jonas, I'm the man on the sticks.
Stickiest boy I ever met.
And we are playing Assassin's Creed Odyssey. Climb this ladder, get in here.
It's Assassin's Creed Valhalla, thank you.
I'm sorry, you're right, dude. That, you know, it comes from the many, many episodes of Assassin's Creed
Odyssey. It comes from the game's basically the same. But anyways.
But, you know, if you're going to do it over, at least do it well.
Yeah, I mean, we're not hunting Doritos this time, so at least there's that.
We don't know yet, dude. It's a little early. Why is this man on fire and running at me? We don't know if there's Doritos yet.
Denzel protecting a little girl.
Creasy!
That was a good movie, dude.
That was an alright movie.
Yeah, it was pretty good, dude.
I'm not mad at you saying that was a good movie.
Dakota Fanning is probably like 25 now. She was like 7 in that movie.
I don't know who Dakota Fanning is.
That was the little girl in that movie. Her name's Dakota Fanning.
Was it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
I worked at Blockbuster in the movie.
I don't know, like, stars.
The only reason I did is because I worked at Blockbuster. People would come in and ask about that stuff, so I just knew who people were. I'd look at the cover boxes constantly. I would have to put movies away all the time. I guess
that would help.
Yeah, dude. I'm like, oh, there's that girl who's in that movie. She's on the cover box. Oh, that's her name. Someone's going to ask for it because they don't know anything about anything. And they're like, that little short blonde girl, dude.
Get off of the thing.
Yeah, dude. She's in the thing with the guy.
The short blonde girl who was... Oh my god! Okay, hold on.
That guy had a name. Oh no, it just says Python. That's not a
Yeah, but
that's not
they're serious though. Dude, they fight! Alright.
Why don't they have numbers, like, so you can gauge their
strength? Oh my god, there's a lot of them.
Yeah, dude. Yeah? Unlock the outer gate. It's destructible from the inside, I guess.
Oh.
Can you throw your axe at him?
Maybe. But look, I'm just gonna go ahead to the outer gate and let my friends in so I don't have to fight everything.
Yeah. The lock is destructible from the inside. Are you on the outside?
I think I broke the lock, didn't I? This is the inside. No, I don't want to fight you. You're too strong.
Yeah, it says unlock the outer gate. The lock... hold on.
Yeah.
It looks like it's even outside of that. That must be like the inner gate. There must be another.
I went to inner.
You went to two. Oh, you went one. Two steps deep. They got outer gates and then inner outer gates.
Oh, okay. Hold on, guys. I got you.
Yeah, let me break this lock so then we can. Can you break the red locks now, dude?
Well, it looks like.
Oh, you can just break the red off.
I can break those red locks at least. Speaking of breaking. Dreadlocks.
Wait, hold on. You still have the same. You knock all the stuff down. And they don't realize.
All right, hold on. Let me grab some health.
Yeah.
Because I'm dying over here. I thought I did what you wanted me to do, guys.
Open it, dude.
Oh my god. What do you want? Look at this. Look at it. You see this?
I did. I saw that guy.
The door's open. Just open the door.
But yeah, like 10 of them would have had a harder time opening it.
Yeah, dude, you got me reaching across the passenger seat to open the door for you. Just use your hands. Don't you hate that?
We both have the same amount of hands.
Don't you hate that? Like reaching over the passenger seat to open the door for the passenger. I hate it. Like, what are you doing?
Yeah.
Just open the door.
What are you doing just opening the door? I mean,
they never
it
know.
Makes sense. I get
right?
it.
Right? Just open the door.
I mean,
because
like you ride with your friends, and your friends just open the door and get in.
I mean, like, you know, like it's locked the first time that they go for it, and then they're like, what are you? And they're like, every time you try to unlock it, they, you know, they try
grab
to open
handle.
It. Yeah, to grab the handle.
Right,
and then you're
the
like...
Same time.
Yeah, and then, like, you're like, hold on a second. And they don't do it, so then you have to, like, you do it again, but you do it in unison again.
And
you're like what are you
each
doing?
Are trying to throw the timing off in the exact same pattern. So
yeah.
Then the second time, you're, like, all, like, a tenth of a second off.
Exactly.
But you both go at the same time.
Yeah, so and it's like, I think at this point, I'm like, you're trying to sabotage it. And now... The locking mechanism is stuck.
And then if it happens a third time,
no.
Then you're like, who's messing with who? Why is one of us messing with each other?
Yeah. And then you just reach over and you just pop the lock manually or whatever, because that's what you used to have to do.
Yeah.
Now what do I have to do? Do I have to break these unlockers?
It says unlock the final gate.
All right.
Which is right there.
This one right here.
So you
easy
knock
enough.
And then open.
All right, I gotta like.
It is amazing that you can just climb a 90-degree smooth surface.
What, dude? You can't.
I've fallen out of practice. It's been a long time. I used to be able to do it in my prime. You know, dude. It's like not like riding a bike.
Hey!
Oh, you got him with your shield, dude. Good for you. So now confront Gorm. Gorm is holed up in the temple. So you just have to fight your way through, I guess. Battle of physical brute strength.
Yeah, physical brutes. I love it. Yeah, but I, you know, like that whole thing has happened to everybody at least once.
Yep. Oh, absolutely. Because it's just like it's funny, dude. The things that happen by happenstance in this world, the things that you couldn't duplicate if you tried like 1,000 times, like, it's just so crazy, the little, like, the 1 in 1,000 chance things that happen where you're both a little bit off, or like, you know, like when you're playing basketball and the ball gets stuck in that little gap between the rim and the backboard, like,
you can't do that if you tried,
but it just happens. Or where the ball lands on the little flat part between the rim and the backboard and stops. It bounces like 3 or 4 times and just stops there. And you're like, how is that even possible? It's like 4 inches wide. You know, it's the stuff like that. Like, we both are the same exact proportion off trying to throw off the cadence to make it work. It's just, it's like stuff you can't duplicate.
It's like Jinx, you owe me a Coke.
Right. Trying is harder than it happening by happenstance. Like, when I used to play volleyball, people would hit the ball. They would hit the net, and then the ball would just literally ride the top of the net all the way down from one side to another. Because they would, like, it would hit the net in the exact right spin, and it would just roll down the net. You're like, you couldn't, if you tried to do that 1,000 times, that would never work. Like, but the happenstance that it hits and spins up and rides the top of the quarter-inch cable.
Have you ever seen Dude Perfect?
Yeah, I've seen those. You know how many times they probably got to try that stuff?
Exactly, dude. It's crazy.
They try all day to hit it once.
Yeah, and then they put it on and get a trillion views.
Right, dude, exactly.
Yeah, that takes a whole day's worth of work.
Oh, yeah, dude. And you know, and sometimes they probably get it quick. And other times, it probably takes all damn day. Because it's like literally that, if it's a 1 in 1,000,000 chance, you can try 1,000 times in a day and maybe you'll get it. But it's 1 in 1,000,000, so you very likely won't, you know?
Exactly. I don't want to do the same thing 1,000,000 times, dude.
No, dude. Like,
because Martin can't get his stuff together.
Right.
It's always Martin's fault too.
I've never watched. I've seen.
Just made up a name.
I was gonna say I've seen some of their old stuff, like when they were like kids doing it in a pool, like back in the day when they were brand new, before they were famous. It would be like, I just remember seeing that Dude Perfect, and they would do that, like, where they toss the ball 8 times across the pool and off the roof and stuff.
Yeah.
Like, those are their original videos, like, way back when. Like, it's just, and now at the end, they do stuff like throwing basketballs from a football stadium in the upper deck and making it in the hoop. You know,
yeah,
you're like,
crazy
oh, okay.
Stuff.
Yeah. That's cool.
Just like, my dude, you probably have, like, arm issues. How many times you've thrown a frisbee?
Right.
Through a gauntlet of flat-screen TVs.
Throwing a basketball into a football stadium 70 times is going to make your arm sore.
Right.
No matter who you are. You are That's why, like, people underestimate, like, quarterbacks in the NFL, the amount they throw a football, how much wear and tear that is on, like, your chest and your arm and, like... Like, that's a lot. Like, baseball pitchers, dude. That's so much wear and tear on your shoulder to, like, throw a 100-mile-an-hour fastball. And then they're just throwing it like, why is everything on fire?
Everything's on fire, dude. I don't know. Some dude set the building on fire when I walked in here.
There's always fire.
But, yeah, football players, dude, they put a lot of wear and tear. They only last, like, 5 years.
Yeah, especially, like, quarterbacks and stuff, dude. It's crazy. But yeah, it's just, it's nuts how the random
coward
shit
Gorm
stuff
fleece.
That
his father dies twice today.
Happens. It's like, it's just, it's nuts. how often that 1 in 1,000,000 sort of thing seems to pop up randomly.
Yeah.
When you're not trying.
I mean, you put enough hours into the world, man, you're going to run into that.
Yeah, exactly. it's right. It's like, I feel like everything in our life is based on a idea. Oh my god, I have the word. Let the coward go. Like a ratio basis. That's not the word I was looking for, but like essentially it's like, you know, today X might happen, but there's only like a 2% chance that's going to happen.
Oh, yeah.
And it's going to happen over and over and over. And eventually that day is going to hit where that 2% chance hits.
Don't get caught up in that, though, because you'll start like getting into like some Final Destination stuff.
You're like, one day I'm just going to walk outside and a spaceship's going to come down and cut my
legs. I mean, it could happen.
Right, dude. Like, there's not a 0.072 chance that.
There's not a zero chance that it couldn't happen.
Right, exactly. Yeah. I got you. Yeah.
Yeah.
There is a limit, I guess, you know, like if you're worried about something that has like less than like a millionth of a chance to happen in a day, you're like, dude, just chill out. Like no one's going to break in your house and stab you today. Like that's
but it could
depending
happen.
Depending on what area you live in, I guess.
If you
live in an area where people break into houses and stab people, then you have a way higher chance than if you live in like the 50th floor of a skyscraper.
I mean, it could happen.
Yeah, dude.
Can I climb in here? I can.
Yeah. I mean, okay, let me ask you this random question.
Go ahead. Give it up. I want to hear it.
How many times in your entire life have you had someone knock on your door of your house that was the wrong place?
Wow. I mean, I can't say not zero. I would say a few times.
Right. Like, I remember when I was married, at like 12 o'clock at night, some random dude was knocking on our door of our apartment. And, like, we had the two kids, my stepkids, and, like, they were freaked out. Like, who's knocking on our door at midnight? And it was just some random dude, and he seemed like he was drunk, and he knocked. And we told him it was the wrong door, and he wandered away. But the same random happenstance could be a crazy person with a gun and shoots your door down and comes in and attacks you. You know what I mean? It's like you open the door, and it's a crazy person. You know, like, that random occurrence is one in a million.
See, and have you seen, like, dude, I saw this on, like, online. There was, like, some lady, like, she was having, like, a mental issue or whatever, and what?
Whoa,
and
she, your chainmail, dude, you got it.
Like, chain flail. And she was just, like, standing outside of this person. It was a ring light, and she was just standing out there, and she had, like, a knife in her hand. And then she just, like, stood outside the door and then just walked away into the darkness.
Right, it's like if you happen to open the door at that moment in time for any reason, there's a lady there with a knife, dude.
You never know.
Right, like the same that guy was like, oh, and walked away. You know, like, yeah, dude, it's just, you know, like, but that's not a rare, it's not a common thing that happens. I think one day here, even somebody knocked on the door like, oh, sorry, dude, wrong. But like, it does happen, but like, yeah, it could just as easily be a killer or a crazy person that knocked your door by accident.
I hope not, dude. I don't need to be dead. I prefer not to be dead.
Well, yes. I mean, but you think about how many hours you've lived in your life, and you've had, like, three people knock on your door that weren't the right person.
Yeah,
like,
that's
a good ratio.
And I've never died either.
Exactly,
that's a
thing. Yeah, we've lived all these days and not died.
I definitely have not died yet.
Yeah. Yeah, I'm on my way, dude. I'm on my way.
I'm going there. I'm getting there.
I'm going to get there.
Yeah, we're getting closer, but it ain't happened yet.
Yeah, right. All right. Like, I mean, I know it's inevitable. It's coming.
Yeah.
But, like, it's not. Nah, I'm good, dude. I got, like, a lot of days.
I'm hoping that they'll just, like, come up with immortality. What? Come on, dude.
Oh, you hit the Matrix again.
But there's gold in them Narn Hills.
That's weird. That's like a village. Why is there a barrier in a village?
Because I am on a story path rail right now, apparently.
Oh, it may not necessarily be you can't go that way. They're just, like, blocking you from, like, okay.
Yeah.
Like, we need to rally you in a little bit.
Yeah, there's a little bit of rallying in this game, too. I'm not mad at it because it prevents me from, like, getting off on a tangent.
Right, right.
Which
we would just go around. Next thing you're like, where are you? And you're like, I don't know. I'm just kind of checking stuff out. Like,
right.
And I get it. It's cool.
Though I do find myself doing things of this nature where I'm just like, well, I'll just climb over that.
Right. Well, it's the easiest path.
Right.
If you can scale a 90-degree wall, why would you not do that or walk around? Oh, look at that waterfall. That's cool.
Dude, I don't want to scale all of that. That's a lot of scaling. Do you see all this?
Yeah, dude. It's like it's like Cobra Commander getting up there, dude. It's like a giant scale.
But the thing is over here. I'm going to climb up the waterfall.
Oh, there you got a matrix again on the waterfall.
Do I?
Yeah, see all the triangles?
Oh, dude, that means I can't go over there. That sucks. All right. Well, F it. We'll go as high as we can.
Crazy.
It does. I like it. What is? Oh, I can't even get up there. Oh,
dude, they're trapping you in. They're boxing. I'm not mad at it. The glass ceiling is literally impenetrable.
They're like, look, we understand the game is big, and you're just going to want to climb.
There eventually
stuff.
Has to be an edge somewhere. Right?
Yeah. They're like, we got to stop you. All
right. Right. There's literally, if you go the other way, you can go for 3 hours and you're at the limit.
Right. It's freaking, it's dynamite proof. That's fine. I appreciate that. I don't even know what to do now. I guess I have to go and talk to this man.
Oh, it's right here, dude. Yeah,
I know, but I wanted to go get the gold.
Oh, you've been trying to speak to this guy for like a long time.
Dude, I want to go look at the gold.
I feel you, dude.
The breath of battle rises from my brow. The skulls will sing of this night.
We have won the day, but
yeah, we did
fled north to King Harald's domain.
Let that bruised piglet run where he may. His father is dead. His clan is no more. We are the masters of Ruyavilke.
Ruyavilke.
The useless cub may grow to be a dangerous wolf.
Eivor, stop. And listen. You have reclaimed your honor. Enjoy the knight's victory. Tomorrow, we will celebrate.
You're right, brother. You are always right.
Wow.
Guthormr, relay news
She's
of our
kill
victory
him, dude.
To your nephew, the king.
I have done so already, Sigurd. He'll be more than pleased.
That is so creepy,
we'll ensure
dude.
You pride of place at his Althing at Ulrichstad.
It's the mustache.
Telling we will come. Battle first,
okay.
Singing songs of glory.
Keep company with kings, and you will soon have a crown of your own.
I've had an
if
epiphany.
The fates have spun it so. Linger here and loot what you can. I will bring news of our victory to father before he leaves for Harald's Althing.
All right, Harald's Althing.
So here's my epiphany, or do we have to end this?
No.
Okay. Okay.
I know, sir. Another time.
Hold on, I'll see what happens. I think you're about to go into...
Another cutscene. There's a chance, but
yeah,
I think they're
going to
give me control now. I feel like I get to get
like,
my spoils
of war.
Like,
yeah, now it's like, okay, go explore, dude, so...
What's your epiphany?
Dude, so mustaches, right? They can be...
They can be
all right, but then they can definitely be creepy, right?
Definitely.
So I was
creepy.
Just like, I think what just hit me is you just said that guy's mustache was creepy.
Yes.
And I think immediately it hit me, and I've never thought this before, what makes a mustache from not creepy to creepy is if it hangs over your upper lip. Like if
upper
it's trimmed
stash.
Up and you can see the lip, you're good. If it's like if it's in your mouth, dude, that's when it becomes creepy because you're like, why would any normal person want to like eat with like their mustache in their mouth and stuff when you can trim it up to like your lip and you're like, dude, I'm good, dude. You can
why
make
would,
it thick and full without it like in your mouth.
Why would anybody want to eat with their mustache?
A valid question.
I don't know. I mean, also, if it's so big that it hangs over the lip is the cutoff point.
Right. Like, if it's into your mouth, like, even, like, on the lip is okay, but you know what I mean, dude. Some of those dudes, their mustache is, like, basically in their mouth.
Like the Wilford Brimley.
Yeah.
That's too much mustache.
Yeah, like, and that's when it starts to become creepy. Like, he pulls it off because he's Wilford Brimley, or did because he's passed away, but, like, a lot of people don't pull it off, and it just looks like sleazy? I don't know.
Are you saying Burt Reynolds looks sleazy? And be honest.
Kinda.
Okay, there we go. Yeah. I just wanted you to come
but
to terms with
but
it.
But he doesn't have like a real bad offensive one either, though, because he's got
it's
the bushy.
Pretty, it's pretty bad.
Like, there's a difference because there's bushy mustaches and there's like the long stringy hair mustaches. The stringy hair over the lip, it's like straight. There's no curl to it. It's just like a oil slick of hair hanging into your crevice, dude. And you're like putting a submarine in and it's just like pushing the hair
Wait,
into your
what?
Mouth.
Why would you put a submarine in your mouth?
Submarine sandwich?
Oh, a grinder.
Yeah, a grinder. your throat in a grinder, dude. And
throating a grinder. It brushes the sesame seeds off so you don't have to...
Right, dude. And who doesn't want their seeds? Like, so when you're pushing it in, the mustache is pushing the seeds off, dude. It's too much, dude.
I'm gonna get in this motherfucker.
I think that should be the... But, dude, I think it is. I think it's the length of the mustache is kind of like it helps with the... It helps or it does not help with the creepy factor. But you got a nice, tight, trim mustache. It looks all right. you know what I mean? Like, not even super tight and trim, but, like, it's just that, it's that, like, fluttering hair into the mouth. I guess maybe that's my contention point.
It's like fluttering hair?
It's, like, it's just, like, thin and wispy, and it's, like, in your mouth, dude.
Yeah, like, if you have to do that much hygiene to your mustache, you pretty much are.
Yeah, dude, like, you gotta be like, and, like, blow your mustache out of your mouth, because it's just... I don't know, dude. Maybe people like it. I mean, people do it, right?
Maybe people like it.
Like, but I couldn't even imagine being, like, a woman kissing a dude with, like, a mustache. Like a mustache is already prickly enough. Like, then you've got, like, Will-O-the-Wisp, like, tugging at your cavities, dude, with his like, lively hair follicles or scratching your gum line, dude. Ew. It's gross, dude. Right, dude? You know what
it
I mean?
It is pretty gross, dude. You're not even wrong.
Anyways, dude, that's my thought on mustaches for the moment. But, yeah, I thought that was...
Don't even ask me how I knew that that's what I was supposed to do, either.
But get that money.
I got to.
This game's pretty fun, dude.
I love a good mustache. What do you call that? Ooh, a good mustache story, a good mustache review. It's good to know. Like
mustache review, huh? They have that?
We should start the mustache review podcast.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Would you like to discuss mustaches? Like, about every thought I have on mustache just came out in the last, like, 8 minutes I've been talking about it. I don't have much more, dude. I don't know if I could do a full, like, 60 on mustaches.
We can do, like, no, we'll do, like, celebrity mustaches.
Dude, I don't.
You don't want to do celebrity mustache?
I don't talk about guys' faces that much.
You don't want
to. Like, specific. Like, talking about them in general, I don't be like, ooh, let's look at this guy's mustache. Ooh, that's creepy.
Makes what? Dude, I don't like the way you said that.
I was just, it's like mustache after dark. Like, just, ooh, that beard is rough and rugged, isn't it?
Wonder what that feel like tangled up in my never mind.
Yeah, no, dude, not, right, exactly. We don't even need to get there.
We can go there though.
Right, dude.
We can.
I think everyone knows what will happen.
They don't know. Some people know.
Yeah, dude. But it's
they can find out though.
Mustaches, dude.
Mustaches.
Like, yeah, dude. Interesting stuff, dude.
So, like, have we ever discussed about, like, how women having mustaches was, like, a thing for a little while there?
Was it?
Yeah. Okay. Absolutely.
Like, they were encouraged to let their hair and their lip grow if they had any?
Okay.
Because not everyone has, you know what I mean? Like,
let me give you a little bit of lore, Jonas. You're familiar of the woman in Friday who had a mustache.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, Miss Pearly.
Okay, so that was not just, like, a wacky joke. That was actually a thing that happened for a short period of time where women would have a slight mustache because sometimes taking care of that hair can be a little difficult to do.
Yeah, you gotta get it waxed off, dude.
Yeah,
that sucks.
Like,
yeah,
all the
it.
Time.
Yeah.
So women would wear mustaches. Now, I'm pretty sure this is a cultural thing, very well could have been, like, I feel like I've seen it with
I've seen it on, like, older ladies because they don't care anymore. They're just like, I'm just gonna let it grow. I'm not gonna wax that anymore.
I mean, and, you know, fair enough, man.
Yeah, dude, I feel it.
I like being able to transition between the both. If I feel like shaving, then, you know,
yeah, dude, I
won't
have
a mustache.
It's weird because I think women feel a pressure to do that. I mean, great.
They should.
Well,
right?
I mean, like,
look,
the facial hair thing.
Call me a misogynist.
Is a lot different than, like, you know, other parts. But they have more pressure to shave, like, everything except, you know. And it's you know, as they get older, they're like, whatever, dude, I have a husband, or, like, I'm good. I'm old. My husband's died. Whatever, you know, like. It's just the stigma is, like, interesting. Where it's like, you know, it's like that's like. They don't, that's, like, women will grow their armpit hair, they'll grow their pubic hair, they'll grow their leg hair, but, like, most women, even, like, the women who grow their other parts of their body hair, always still do their face hair.
Would you date a woman with a mustache? Let's just be real.
I mean, like,
let's stop being PC and get down to some real shit right here, all right? Would you date a chick with a mustache?
I mean, like, I
don't give
Like, are you talking Burt Reynolds or like has some hair? You know what I mean? There's a difference. Is she full-blown Wilford Brimley?
Is there a difference?
There is.
Is there a difference?
If they got a couple hairs or they got a Wilford Brimley. Like, I've dated girls who have a few hairs, but not like enough. Even if it grew, it would be anywhere near a mustache.
Yeah, but then they take care of
it.
Yeah,
but like you're talking like, is it like she's just like, oh, I have a little bit of hair, or oh, I just stopped it. I'm full blown.
She has like as much mustache as I do currently.
Like a beard?
No.
She has a full blown beard?
No, but I have like a light mustache.
Dude, I don't know if I can get past. I don't know, dude. It just depends. If they're all right, I guess. I don't know, dude. I would have a hard time probably.
All of that work, dude. Yeah. All of that work, and I can't even get to it. It is literally 100 meters and that way.
I don't think it would be merely the fact that it's a mustache. It's just merely the fact that I don't find mustaches attractive. The same as if, like, I don't find girls with short hair attractive, I would be more apt to date a girl with long hair.
That's the PC answer.
What? No, dude. It's like, but, dude, if girls having mustaches was normal everyone had one and, like, some didn't, you'd be like, whatever.
The last time you looked up mustache porn?
Never.
On the next episode.
I guess, right? That's all time we have for this episode. Please make sure to like and subscribe. If you've done that, new Twitch with this guy.
We have TNT Dinomight on Twitch. twitch.tv/TNT_crazytown.
For Jonas.
TNT.
We'll catch you on the next one. We are out.
God damn it.